So you're looking to get this beast of a weapon, the Sigma 2 Gold. I don't blame you, it looks pretty good and it counts towards dark matter. The Sigma 2 is currently the only rocket launcher in the game that can lock onto enemy vehicles. However, that is just about the only thing that it has got going for itself. In order to fire the Sigma 2, whether it's locked on or free fire, you must aim down sight. However, the aim down sight time is incredibly slow and the weapon itself is absolute garbage. For a start, if you're not locked onto a vehicle, it does not shoot straight. This makes hitting enemies incredibly difficult, and if you are lucky enough to get your rocket close to an enemy, the splash damage on this weapon is absolutely god-awful. As you can see, a rocket exploding right next to somebody still does not kill them. In order to kill them in one hit, you must direct impact them. There are just so many negatives to this weapon, it absolutely sucks, but that does make that final feeling of relief when you get it gold even more satisfying. Two! Come on, come on, come on, that's gotta be it. Yes! Finally! Oh my god! Yes, kill me all you want, I don't care. Oh, I'm not gonna lie, getting this weapon gold is a daunting task. It is horrible, it's a long grind, but you're in luck because today I'm here to help you. I've completed the grind, I've got this gun gold, I've done the research, all so that you guys don't have to. In this video, I'm going to show you guys the quickest way to unlock all of the camo challenges, so leveling the weapon up, and then I'll be giving you detailed explanations of how to do every single camo challenge for this weapon, highlighting which ones are easy and no problem, and the ones which are harder, I'll go into a little bit more depth. Sounds pretty good, right? Let's get started. So there are three decent ways to level the Sigma up, and I'll talk about them in order from best to worst. So we'll start with the best way, and this is zombies. For a start, it's a given that you're going to be using double weapon XP on the Sigma 2. You really don't want to be spending long on this weapon whatsoever. If you just play zombies with the Sigma 2, you can play with friends, do whatever you want, just have a nice chill time, really focus on getting those kills, pack a punch the Sigma 2, fully upgrade it, blow those zombies up, you will get this gun up to level 30, which is when you unlock all the challenges in no time. It's a nice, relaxed, stress-free way of leveling this gun up, and trust me, you want to be minimizing the stress that this gun causes you as much as you can. However, I appreciate zombies is not for everyone, so let's move on to the next method. The second best option for leveling the Sigma 2 is actively in multiplayer, specifically Fireteam Dirty Bomb. So by actively, I mean you are spawning in, you are instantly swapping to the Sigma 2, and then you are just trying to destroy any sort of streak, whether it's a spy plane or any sort of vehicle that you see, as much as you possibly can. The reason why Fireteam Dirty Bomb is so good for this is because people literally get UAVs, counter UAVs, attack helicopters, just out of boxes in the map. They don't have to earn them in any way, so there are constantly things for you to be destroying in Fireteam Dirty Bomb, which is why it's so good. This is the class I like to be using when I'm in Fireteam Dirty Bomb, so you can basically ignore the primary, that's just there for if you run out of ammo or whatever. The tacticals and lethals, not too bothered, but the field upgrade is important. The assault pack, this basically means you've got pretty much infinite ammo for if you sit in a good spot on the map, and we'll go into this later. It really lets you just lock down a certain zone and you can just sit there and blow stuff up all day long. Engineer is great for seeing enemy vehicles and score streaks in the air. Gearhead is really nice for getting those assault packs thick and fast. You can just constantly have yourself supplied with ammo, which is absolutely fantastic. And Spycraft, this one is pretty rogue, but it's really good in Fireteam Dirty Bomb. But it basically means whenever you're looking at the map, trying to find enemy vehicles, those pesky counter UAVs will not be affecting you in any way. And of course, the wildcard Danger Close increases your rocket launch ammo from 2 shots to 4 shots. So the third and final way to level this weapon up is in regular multiplayer, and it's a passive way of doing it. In a way, this is the most efficient way of getting dark matter. And what this method involves is you basically use a primary of your choice. So say you're trying to get the AK-47 gold, but in your secondary, you've got the Sigma 2. And now whenever an enemy calls in a score streak or whatever, you're going to bring that out and you're going to destroy it. And by doing that, it's not going to be the absolute fastest way to get just the Sigma 2 leveled up. Once you get the Sigma to level 30, then you can really focus on getting those harder challenges done. So the passive multiplayer option is a great one if you're focusing on doing other guns at the same time. So you've leveled the Sigma 2 up, congratulations. That's the easy part out of the way. Now it's time to go through each and every camo challenge on this weapon, and I will talk you through how to get them done. So the challenge you start off with, unlocked at level 1, is the spray challenge. This is quite simply get 50 kills. This might seem quite hard because of the other challenges later on, for example the double kills, you're gonna get this one done anyway, so we're not really gonna go into any more detail about this challenge because it is that simple, and the difficulty for this one is easy mode. Next up, unlocked at level 5, are the stripes challenges. Now this is to destroy 50 enemy equipment, score streak, or vehicles. Again, this challenge will get done alongside the other challenges. For example, you've got to destroy 50 ground vehicles or streaks later on anyway, so literally this challenge will just get done when you're doing that one alone. You've guessed it, difficulty for this one, easy mode. Now at level 10, we unlock the classic skins. Things start picking up here. You've got to get 20 22 killstreaks with this gun. On its own, this challenge would be pretty hard. Getting a 2 killstreak with this weapon is no easy feat, but because you have to get 25 double kills as the last challenge on this weapon, that will literally get this challenge done anyway. So on its own, the difficulty of this challenge would be pretty annoying. But I'm going to downgrade that to easy mode because of the double kill challenge later on. Now, this is a fun one. Unlocked at level 15 is the geometric challenges. This is to destroy 50 enemy ground-based score streaks or vehicles. In order to know that you have destroyed a vehicle and it has counted towards this challenge, you must get either the breakdown or the takedown medal. This may not sound that bad, but the only score streaks you can destroy that will count towards this challenge are RCXDs and sentry turrets. Just think how many times you actually see those score streaks in the game. Pretty much never. So this means we're really relying on destroying the vehicles. The absolute best place to do this by far is Fireteam Dirty Bomb. There are so many vehicles there, the map is so big, people do hop in them at all points of the map. Really keeping your eye out for them is absolutely key to getting this challenge done. Again, we're using the Fireteam Dirty Bomb class that I explained at the beginning of this video, but the best way to get this challenge done in Fireteam Dirty Bomb, what you do is when you respawn, you simply pull your parachute immediately, float in the air, and check your map constantly whilst you're floating. Now, if you don't know how to get this map open, you bring up the scoreboard and then you press RB or R1. Whilst you're watching this map, as soon as you see a vehicle turn red and an enemy gets into it, you cut that parachute, bring the Sigma 2 out, lock onto that vehicle and destroy it. And you just want to be doing this as many times as you can in Fireteam Dirty Bomb. You can expect to get anywhere between 5 and 20 ground vehicles destroyed in one game of Fireteam Dirty Bomb. Just depends on the lobby you're in. But one tip for when you're destroying vehicles whilst you're flying through the air, don't shoot a locked on missile from absolute miles away because it just gives the enemy time to get out. And if they get out, you won't get that crucial breakdown or takedown medal. There is a bit of a grace period, I think it's about 1 or 2 seconds where an enemy can get out of the vehicle, and then if you destroy it within that grace period, you still get the medal and this still counts towards the challenge. But to be safe, don't shoot those rockets from across the map because people will just get out and you won't get it, and then that's a wasted vehicle. Another strategy in Fireteam Dirty Bomb is to find a vantage point that's nice and high up on the map. For example, on Ruka, there's that massive tower. As you can see, you land on it, you've got a great vantage point of pretty much the entire map, and whenever you see enemy vehicles, whether it's air or ground, you can just destroy them from here. It's absolutely fantastic. The only issue with this spot is that you can't put down your assault packs on top of it for some reason. I guess it's kind of fair enough. But that means once you've fired your 4 rockets, you do have to go down and either kill yourself or use your assault pack and then try and kill enemies whilst you're on the ground. Now, for this challenge, you can also do it in multiplayer. I would not recommend it because the amount of vehicles that you see in multiplayer, so specifically combined arms, are nowhere near as many as you find in Fireteam Dirty Bomb. But if, for whatever reason, you really want to stay away from Fireteam Dirty Bomb, that's fine, that's fair enough. Go to combined arms and just destroy all of the jet skis, the snowmobiles, the tanks, the big boats. This challenge will take slightly longer doing this method, but it's perfectly reasonable to do, and again, you can do it passively alongside other guns. If you are using the combined arms playlist, then Armada and Crossroads are absolutely the maps you're looking for, so if you can, just try and stick to those two maps. I would rate the difficulty of the geometric skins as pretty annoying. Next up, unlocked at level 20, are the Flora skins. This is to destroy 50 aerial score streaks or vehicles. I've already kind of touched upon this, but it's a pretty simple challenge. Basically, just destroy all spy planes, counter UAVs, attack helicopters, even gunships and chopper gunners that you see, just destroy them all. Any game mode is fine for this. You will get multiple in every single game that you play, whether it's multiplayer, combined arms, or Fireteam Dirty Bomb. But as I've said, Fireteam Dirty Bomb, it is so easy for everyone to get UAVs and counter UAVs that if you want to get this challenge done in the quickest way possible, Fireteam Dirty Bomb is the place to go. Because of this, the difficulty rating for this camo challenge is easy mode. Unlocked at level 25 are the science skins. This is another vehicle focused challenge where you've got to destroy 3 vehicles in one game 10 times. This challenge will happen whilst you're doing the flora and geometric challenges. You've got to destroy 100 vehicles in total for those ones, and I'd be pretty concerned if you're not destroying more than 3 in a game because then they would take forever. So this is a super easy challenge, but if you want a great spot for destroying vehicles just all game long, this is in Fireteam Dirty Bomb on the sanatorium map. If you go to this mid-level balcony, as you can see parachuting in, make sure you press your mantle button when you get to that ledge so that you climb up onto it. You just sit there with an ammo pack. You have a great view of the entire map. It's very uncontested. Hardly anyone knows about this balcony or how to get there. So if you get this map, I highly recommend coming here to destroy as many vehicles as you can. You might have guessed it, the difficulty rating for this challenge is easy mode. So the final challenge you unlock with the Sigma 2 at level 30 are the psychedelic skins. In order to get these challenges done, you must do 25 double kills with the Sigma 2. Just thinking about this, it brings back memories, bad memories. This challenge is where 90% of your pain is going to come from, getting this gun gold. I'm going to tell you that now. So before we start on these challenges, the first tip is you need to be patient. You cannot expect to get this done in one game, in 2 games, in 3 games. It's going to take you many, many games. So have a patient mindset and go into this when you're in a good mood. It's probably going to bring that mood mood down a bit. You need to start off in a good mood or you will be rage quitting every game, so just be mentally prepared for this challenge. Because the Sigma 2 has such pitiful damage, unless you direct impact someone, the best way to get the double kills is by meleeing your enemies. Melee kills with the Sigma 2 out count towards this challenge. They do count as kills, eliminations, whatever, on this weapon. So if you melee two enemies in quick succession, that's a double kill, that works fine. Or you can melee one, shoot the other with the rocket launcher, that works fine as well. Whatever combination you want to do. The gameplay I'm using in the background to demonstrate this for you is taken from my RNG camo mastery series, which is Road to Dark Matter basically. But the order that I unlock the gold camos for every weapon in is decided by a random number generator. Unfortunately, I had to do the Sigma recently, which is why I'm bringing you this video. Feel free to go give it a watch, there'll be a link in the description and above. So the best way to get these double kills done with the Sigma 2 is in Nuketown Hardcore. I've seen many videos saying don't do hardcore, it makes it much harder. I tried doing it in core and honestly it was just garbage. Sure, enemies don't one shot you with their bullets, but you now have to melee them twice in order to get the kill. And yes, you can soften them up with molotovs or whatever, but it's just really not that effective. Nuketown is just the best place for it. For this strategy to work best, you need to be able to close down the gap between you and your enemies, and the best way to do this is put smokes on and just chuck them everywhere. They block those lines of sight, they let you get into sneaky positions where you can get behind enemies and get your double kills done that way. Also, this spot on Nuketown underneath the balcony on either house is a great spot. Apparently, enemies just don't see you here until they learn you're going there the whole time. They just don't expect it and they don't check that position, so it's great to just sit there, be patient, and then when you see two enemies, run out and melee them both, get those double kills in. Also, if you do melee one guy and you can't see anyone else, do just fire a rocket at a high traffic area. Better to fire a rocket and hope for the best to get that second kill than to just give up any chance of getting that double kill. So aside from the hardcore Nuketown melee double kills, a great strategy that was pointed out to me by one of my subscribers is a great tip, is in fighting Dirty Bomb, when you're trying to get the other challenges done, when you're in that first plane, don't drop out straight away or do anything. Just let yourself AFK drop out, and chances are there's going to be enemies that are also AFK, so when you land on the floor next to them all, you just kill them. And as you can see from this clip, there were actually loads of people who were AFK at the start of this one game of fighting Dirty Bomb that I played. Unfortunately, I got butchered by this guy with a knife, but you can see that it is a perfectly good strategy. And when you're playing Fireteam Dirty Bomb to get the vehicle destroys done, just do this at the start of every single game. And if you're lucky, you'll get most of the double kills done just from doing that. Another option that kind of works is in combined arms. Basically, you sneak up behind enemy snipers and you hope that there's a couple within close proximity of each other. You go behind them, you melee them twice, you kill them, and you get that double kill. I'm gonna say it right now. The difficulty rating for this challenge is criminal. You made it to the end of the video. Good job. I really hope these tips help you get this gun gold as quick as you possibly can. It was not fun for me when I got it gold. I absolutely hated every minute of it. All I ask is that if these tips have helped you in any way, please do drop a like, drop me a comment, let me know that it's helped you, or let me know if you're struggling with something and I will reply. I'll give you some extra advice if you need it. Or if you're feeling really generous, drop a subscribe, come visit my channel. It'd be great to have you in this community. We will welcome you with open arms. Anyway, best of luck getting the Sigma 2 gold. I really hope you get it done nice and easily. I'll see you next time.